Good morning, everyone, respected chairpersons and moderators. This is a small case, though there were a lot of adrenaline secretion during the procedure. So this is a 45 years male admitted with acute MI of 1 hour duration, smoker hypertensive, and there is history of stressful life. ECG showed extensive hyperacute changes in the anterior wall with features of myocardial infarction. Echocardiography showed hypokinetic anterior, lateral, and septal walls. Tropi was positive. So this was the presentation. So we thought that since the patient came within an hour, so let us give the benefit of primary PCI. So it was engaged at LCA, and there was total cutoff in the LAD. And we thought that we won't go for any thrombosuction in this particular case because of the guidelines that are there, that a routine thrombosuction is rather class 3 indication. So we wanted to dilate at different levels. We put the guide wire. So this is the total cutoff at LAD. So put the guide wire, it went easily. And then we tried to dilate with the 2x12 millimeter balloon at different levels. But what we saw, that after the injection was given, the dye was not coming. There was still a lot of thrombus, and we are not being able to determine which length of the stent can be deployed, though the usual practices are long stent can be deployed even without seeing much by dilating the proximal part of the area with the thrombus. But we thought that let us find out something, since we didn't want to use the thrombosuction catheter. So we put a micro catheter, and at different levels we put the dye, and found out at which level there was no occlusion. As you can see here, that at this particular point, beyond that, there was no block. So we could find out the length of the stent which is to be deployed in this particular artery, and we put a long stent, and that was deployed, inflated, and after that, the post-deployment injection showed this kind of a flow. And the thing is that after the deployment as well, there was a little bit of slow flow. We gave all kinds of medications like adenosine and other things which are usually practiced, like Nicorandil and all. And ultimately, after the deployment of the stent, we found that flow was okay, and this is the final result. And the take-home message for this is that use of microcatheter may be quite handy to localize the distal part of thrombus, and the length of occlusion during primary PCI prevents unnecessary balloon dilatations, which might cause a lot of problems during the primary PCI, especially in the background of dissection and all. And if it does, gives the idea of the exact length of the stent to be deployed. Thank you very much for patient hearing.